So now that we've done the second part of this straight line motion lab, what we're going to do is talk about the analysis. So for part A, the car going along the distance should be a straight line just like you graphed in lab number one. Fit it with the straight best fit curve, draw the XY scatter plot in Excel, fit with a linear trend line. Now, for part B, it's a little bit different. So here's some example. Here's some data that I took. Okay? Plotted it out. If you use a much longer X scale, this may look linear. If it looks linear, shrink it up. It should look like it's not going to be a straight line. That to get from the origin to here would be a line approximately around where my arm is, but then all the data lines up in a much steeper line. Okay? That's because we have acceleration. As the cart moves along our different distances, it speeds up, so it covers more distance in the same amount of time. If this is in Excel, for those of you working in Excel, again, make an XY scatter plot that will look like this. Then when you fit the trend line, what you want to do is actually use an exponential function where the exponent is 2. Okay, because what this is this is parabolic in shape. It's like the right side of a parabola. Because the best fit curve for my data is a smooth line that gets as close to my data as possible. This is probably about as close as I can get freehanding it. I would probably, if I had pencil, I'd erase it again and maybe even try a little bit better. But this parabola is an exponential of order 2 on the trend line. This is what you should get in the end. And I'm not worried about the slope, because the equation is different, so the interpretation is different. Again, part A, I should have XY with a straight line. Part B, I should have this curve. Good luck writing up the rest of your lab. Look forward to reading it. So, now that we've taken the data for the projectile lab, we're going to talk about how to do the analysis. So the analysis really is a graph. You've done the calculations, you averaged out the time, gotten the speed for the ball, the average speed of the ball when it leaves the table. You measured how far away it traveled from the end of the table. And now what we're going to do is actually make our chart, our graph. So what we do is we graph on the x-axis, we're actually graphing our speed, vx, in meters per second. Here on the x-axis and on the y-axis we have exp for experiment, our experimental distance, the distance we measured the ball going out. Not xcal, which is the calculated, it's the theoretical distance it travels based on our theoretical prediction based on the height and the time that that should fall, how far it goes out. Now, what I've done is I've just put some data on here, and what I notice is, as my speed goes up, also my distance goes down. It goes down by quite a bit. This is my indication that I didn't do things correctly somehow. Go back, take your data, and put it on and graph it again. Not so bad this time. Now it's closer to being in a line. So now I'm going to go and do my best fit curve. Or in Excel, you've done the XY scatter plot so it looks like this. Then what we do is you press buttons to do, you're going to add a linear trend line. But I'm going to figure out what's my best fit curve. But I want to keep the origin in play here as a data point because If I have no speed coming off the table, it should drop straight down, and this distance should be zero as well. So physically, this origin is kind of a data point. So just use this like a lever. Yeah, that gets, it gets closer. This is probably going to be the best one I got. And you want to draw a straight line. I didn't draw a straight line because it's harder for me to hold it. Also, it's better if you have a clear ruler to see how far above and how far below you are. This is pretty good. So now what I'm going to do is calculate the slope. And that slope should be the same as the time I calculated. This slope should be equal to what I calculated for ty. And this is what question one asks you to do, is to compare those two values because they should be the same. Question two asks you about sources of error, and then that's the lab. Good luck. So then I'm going to calculate the slope. And in this case, the slope is going to be equal to one of our physical values. So let's step back and think about what this means, okay? We know speed is equal to distance over time. That means distance is equal to speed times time. And we've covered this, starting in unit 2. Except in this experiment, what I've done is I have my distance from the end of the table. I have my speed from the end of the table. And I have my fall time. Now, if I think about that similar to the equation of a line, this line, I'm going to erase the B because the y-intercept is the origin. Remember, we use the origin. It's zero. My x value, my experimental x value is my y. My slope, I'm going to come back to that because my, now my x, this is where it gets tricky. My x is an x. My x-coordinate, my x-axis is the speed. So my drop time, my t, is the slope. So this slope value should be the same as my fall time. And if you use a table that is 75 centimeters tall, you'll have a fall time of about 0.4 seconds. A little bit higher if you get closer to a meter, a little bit shorter, a little bit lower, shorter time, below 0.4 seconds, for the shorter you get. But this time, and this slope, the ty and the slope should be the same. That's what question number one is about. Question number two is about the sources of error. Think about that and put down your best answer, and I look forward to reading your lab report.